And he said, he got it straight in here. And Europe, will you definitely hold a referendum? You know, we should go, oh, bloody brand these bloody questions. No, no. Oh, you're going right into Europe, into federal Europe, you don't care, whatever may come, sell Britain out. Did he say that to bloody brand? No. But anyway, Cameron gets it, because he's trying to be all right. You know, he's winning points for his mate that wants to be bloody federal Europe, so that's a bit rich, really. But, yeah, he's putting on the airs that he's part of the bloody Tory grandee now, Mark. And he says, you know, trying to show up his right-wing people. Called a bit brief, I suppose. And he says, are you going to hold a referendum no matter what? And Cameron's dear, and he's sitting on the bloody fence, because he's like, he still wants to be new, because he's like, not UKIP, is he, old Cameron? I want a bit of political Europe, but not that much political Europe. Well, no, I don't want a total fuck's sake. European Union is going down the road. The whole body organisation of the European Union is, their whole agenda is to go down the road of federal Europe. So you're either in that house or you're out. They're going towards one country. You're either in that block or you're out of it, that block. That's simple as that. That is a question that should be put to the British public. That is beyond the powers of MPs to hold, really. That's a referendum issue. Whether you want to give up Britain or not, sell it off to a federal state. You can't still piss about in the bloody fence sitting like Cameron is and differing. Oh, I might give you a referendum, I might not. He says, you're going to get a referendum if it's still being debated, right, in Europe. And that leaves, like, the Irish just voted yes because a lot of bribes, which will come from England, actually. England put so much money into that Europe that the money has got to go whoosh and back into Ireland. So they're voting for their piece of cake, their bribe, piece of silver, whatever. So for all those bombs and bullets we've had to put up with, you know, oh, yeah, we'll go back to Britain and whatever, as long as the money's coming down the road. So, a bit of sedate there. So put up with all that crap for nothing. So Cameron says, yeah, well, this still being debated in Europe, I'll definitely hold the referendum for the British people. He might as well just, you know, say, all the facts and all the figures say we're going, you know, pull out. Oh, God knows. We should have the referendum anyway. Perhaps we'll get a few bribes like Ireland. Might have a bit of a more leverage. Might cut our bloody money we've got to pump into it down a bit. So he says, oh, we'll hold a referendum if Poland and Czechoslovakia still haven't signed up. What the f... They're all going down the Federal Europe road. And he's saying, well, if it's a fait accompli, just say we're going to still give the English people a vote on the referendum whether they want to join a Federal Europe or not. Simple as that. Because it is going down a federal road. The whole body organisation, the body politic of Europe is going down a federal road. Everyone knows that. He said, he sat off, oh, I don't know, I might not, no, I don't think I will, but I'd have to, their own manifesto is, we're looking at it again. And Andrew Marr says, well, if you actually say you're going to hold a referendum no matter what, you would actually delay the Czech and Polish votes and all that. They would hold the whole thing up, really, because they know that you're coming around the corner with your referendum. It would tie up. He says, and Cameron says, oh, don't know, he would, you know. He's sat fence, divvied. He's not going to be a strong leader. He's going to be like, you know, he's too young, I think. He ain't forceful. A bit baby. He's trying to suck up to the Greens, he's suck up to everybody. He's trying to be like, not like the others, like forceful. It's because the bloody British public is so lefty, really. So liberal and so lefty. That's why the bloody got more queuing up at Calais, really. Because they're so like bloody soft. Because Cameron is sucking up, you see, if he said, right, I'm having a referendum no matter what, everyone knows, all of Europe, they all know, right, straight off the bat, that would be us out of Europe. Because that's why all the polls show, all the polls say, they don't need a referendum, all the polls show that we'd be pulled out of Europe, right? So we don't actually need a referendum. But then Cameron's, it seems Cameron's worried about getting some flack from the Europeans saying that he's anti-Yaz and all that. And then that'd be news against him in the election. That's what it must be. It's right like that. So Cameron's big thing is that he doesn't want to influence. Yes, I can't say whether I'm holding a referendum or not, because I don't want to influence other countries, checking polls, that want to go into a federal Europe. They're going to, whether they want a federal Europe or not, and like that's got anything to do with Britain. And he's going, oh, I don't want to say nothing in case it influences them. Who cares about them? This is about Britain. Saving Britain. British people, British voters, British choice. What's it got to do? Why is Brand sitting on the fence about Polish and Czech? What's that? Anything? If Britain's totally independent, right, of Europe and everything like that, what the fuck's it got to do with bloody whatever the Czech and Polish people think? This is why Cameron's talking bull. That's why he's talking bull. Because it's got nothing to do with the Czechs and Poles, what they think. You know what I mean? It's madness. And it's British choice, not bloody Czech and Polish choice. He said, oh, I don't want to be chosen by the Irish. But yeah, you don't influence the bloody Czech and Poles. And this is another reason why this is all bull. Because do they think they not, the Czech and Poles don't know the opinion of the English on the referendum and how they would vote and how Cameron is saying no, or perhaps they are confused because Cameron keeps sitting on the bloody fence. They're saying, well, but is he going to swing this way or not? That's why they're looking at Cameron. All the bloody British people are saying, like, we don't want to go into Europe, be a federal Europe, and Cameron's going, oh, hold on a minute, I want to sit on the fence a bit more. What the? I don't influence their federal votes, right? They're voting for a federal Europe, and I don't influence them. What the hell? You should be speaking for British people. Never mind them. Start influencing. Get your bloody way. That's what politicians should do. That's what you're about. You're influencing the other people. Not sitting the things that I don't. So the only reason he's doing that must be he's up to something himself. Mucking about.